Hello, I'm Mensah Augustine, and welcome to my lesson on differential equations. This is lesson 3. Please, if you have not watched my video on lesson 1 and 2, check the description for that video. In this lesson, we'll be looking at linear differential equations and nonlinear differential equations. Please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the notification button for more videos. In this tutorials, you understand linear differential equations and nonlinear differential equations. So let's move straight to the point. We talk about linear differential equations. These three conditions must be satisfied before the differential equation should be linear. If any one of these conditions is not satisfied, then the differential equation becomes nonlinear. So let's look at the condition one after the other. The unknown function or the dependent variable and its derivatives have degree 1. There is no product of the unknown function or the dependent variable and or its derivatives. Then condition 3. No transcendental function of the unknown function and or its derivatives occur in the differential equation. Now, the general linear differential equation is of the form a subscript n x y to the power n x up to a naught of x y of x equal to f of x. Now, if you look at the general form, it can be seen that each term of the left hand side is a coefficient that is a function of the independent variable. Here, the independent variable is x, and a second factor that is either the dependent variable, here the dependent variable is y, or one of its derivatives. So now let us take examples to improve our understanding. Now, example 1, if we consider d squared y on the x squared plus sine into bracket x plus y equal to sine x. Here, this is the only derivative that we have here, and its degree is 1. If you watch lesson 2, you understand the degree. But if you look at sine into bracket x plus y, sine is a transcendental function, and it contains the dependent variable. So we say that this is a nonlinear. Now let's take the next example. You look at d squared y on the x squared minus tx plus ln x equal to 0. If we look at this one too, here the only derivative we have here has degree 1. So condition 1 is satisfied. Here we have t times x. This is the independent variable. So let's move on. We have ln of the independent variable. So here this is a linear. This is linear. Note that this is a transcendental function, but x is not the dependent variable. If I want to make this one non-linear, then it means that I have to put y here. If you put y here, this becomes a non-linear. But once we have x, the independent variable here, this one is a linear differential equation. Now let's take the next example. We are going to take y prime prime plus 2y prime minus 6y equal to x squared plus cosine of x. Now here, the degree of this one is 1. The degree of this derivative is 1. Here, this is the independent variable, and here we have cosine of the independent variable. So here, this is also linear. This is also linear. Let's take the next example. We have dy on dx equal to 1 minus xy plus y cube. Here, this one has degree 1. Now let us take the condition 1. Say the unknown function or the dependent variable and its derivative have degree 1. This is the dependent variable and the degree here is 3. So this one becomes nonlinear. Now let's take the next example. We have into bracket 3x squared plus y squared dx plus 2xy dy equal to 0. Now let us divide through by dx and dx so that dx dx will become 1, it will cancel out. Now therefore dy dx which has degree 1, but here we have the unknown function y multiplying its derivative. So here this function becomes what? Nonlinear. Very simple as that. Now let's take the next example. Okay, if we take our y into bracket x prime prime to the power 3 plus x prime to the power 4 minus x equal to 0. Here, the derivative of x is being raised to the power 3. And here, the derivative of x here is also being raised to the power 4. But you were saying that the unknown function, so here x is the unknown function, and its derivative have degree 1, but here the degree is 3. So this one becomes what? Nonlinear. And moreover, we are having, okay, this is not x. I was thinking that is x. So this one becomes nonlinear. Now let us take another example. We have del y of x on del x equal to y of x squared. So this is what? A nonlinear. Why is it nonlinear? Because we have the dependent variable being raised to the power 2. So the degree here is 2, not 1. So this one becomes nonlinear. Let's take the next example. We have into brackets the cube y on the t cube all to the power 3 minus dx on the t plus the cube root of x equal to 1. So clearly you can see that this one, the degree here is 3, but you say it must have degree 1. So this one becomes what? A nonlinear. Now let us consider this one. We have cosine of y dy on dx plus sine x equal to 0. Now if you look at this one, we have a transcendental function that contains the independent variable. So we now consider this one. Let's put it there. We have dy on dx, and dy on dx has degree 1. But here we have cosine of y multiplying dy on dx. So cosine of the dependent function will make it nonlinear. And moreover, we have the dependent function multiplying its derivative. So this one becomes nonlinear. Now let's take another example, and I hope you are enjoying the lesson. Please subscribe to my channel. Now let's move on. If we consider this one, I have here dx on dt is equal to sine t squared cosine of x. So here, note that this x is the dependent variable. So once we have cosine of x here, this one becomes nonlinear, because we are saying that no transcendental function of the unknown function and or its derivatives. So this one becomes nonlinear.
If we take del y on del t plus del y on del x equal to y ln x. So here, you can see that the degree here is 1. The degree here is 1. So the condition 1 is satisfied. Here we have y times ln x. So ln x, this is a function of x. Here, x here is independent. X here is what? Independent. So this partial differential equation is linear. It's linear. But if we interchange the position of x and y, it becomes what? Non-linear, because here ln is a transcendental function and it is containing the independent variable. So it becomes a non-linear. But if we maintain it as what we have, it is a linear differential equation. Now if I have d squared theta on d t squared plus a on x sine theta equal to 0. Clearly, you can see that sine is a transcendental function and the sine is containing theta, and theta is the dependent variable. So this one becomes non-linear. Let's take another example. I have del m on del t minus del m on del u equal to ln m. Let me use red marker for the m. Equal to ln m. So ln is a transcendental function and it contains m, the dependent variable. So this becomes what? Non-linear. And let us take our last example. We have del x on del t plus del x on del y plus x equal to e exponent x minus y. So if we consider this one, this has degree 1, this has degree 1. And if you look at this one, okay, this also has degree 1 because this is the unknown function. Its degree is 1. So if you consider this one, we have e exponent x dot e exponent negative y. So we have a transcendental function containing what? We have a transcendental function here containing the independent variable. You see that the independent variable? We have a transcendental function containing the dependent variable x. You see that here the dependent variable is x. And here e is being raised to the power x. So since e is being raised to the power of the dependent variable, this becomes what? Non-linear. But if we write this as del x on del t plus del x on del y plus x equal to e to the power y, this one is linear. It is linear because this has power 1, this has power 1, and this e is being raised to the power of the independent variable y. Very simple as that. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the notification button for more videos. If you have any question related to differential equations, leave it at the comment section. You can follow me on my Facebook page, Maths with Vim. Bye bye.